Today's tutorial, how to make origami style letters digitally. You can take the same method to create all kinds of digital origami, even origami style logos. To start this design process of making digital origami, it's a good idea to do some research on Google. Have a look at how actual paper origami designs look and how they're made. This will give you a good idea of the kind of style that you want to keep in mind when creating your designs. I'm going to bring some guides down by dragging my cursor from the ruler edge. If you cannot see any rulers, then go up to View, Rulers and Show Rulers, or you can hit Command R and this should appear. Because origami uses paper strips, I want to make an equal size area to work with within these guides. I'm going to make a lowercase a, which is pretty much square, so I want to make a square ruler space. Select the pen tool, and then instead of clicking the color option, click the gradient one right here. We then want to choose our color gradient, which will be the color for our work. To open the gradient window, go to Window, Gradient. You will want to choose a dark and light tone of the same color, as you want to represent shadow and light on the design. I want to go with blue for my origami design. You can double click this icon to open up the color settings. Once you have your gradient color ready, you can use the pen tool to start making the design, referring back to the research on Google for origami. It is best to create each segment at a time. To change the gradient for each segment, select the black arrow and highlight the shape. In the gradient window, you can change the direction of the gradient as well as the gradient itself. If you cannot see color choices like on my screen, click the drop down arrow in the top corner here and select either RGB or CMYK. Carry on with each segment, making sure that they align perfectly. You do not want any space between each segment. Notice how my gradient has the shadow pushed to one side. This gives the impression of folded paper on your design. This third segment of my design is on top, so it has more light than shadow, if that makes sense. To save us time, I will go ahead and adjust my gradients and my shapes, so see you soon. Right, as you can see, I've changed the shape of my A, and I've made the shadow less dark, so it's less harsh and blends in more across the gradient. Now I'm going to move on to my capital uppercase A. I'm going to make this one more abstract, and I want to make a triangle shape, so I'm going to bring down some guides that will help me with that. To save time, you can highlight half of the shape that is symmetrical. Hold down Alt until you see this icon appear and click and drag. With the new shape selected, go up to Object, Transform and Reflect. I'm just changing my gradients to give it a 3D paper effect. I want to add a little fold along the bottom here, just to make it look more stylish and 3D. you can go back with the white arrow cursor and click and drag any point on your shape to change it like this. Okay, once you have your origami shapes, you may want to make them an extra bit more cool. We can do that. We need to add a shadow or a reflection, and that's very easy to do. Select all of the segments of one of your shapes like this, and then either press Command G to group them, or go up to Object Group. Then again, by holding down Alt and dragging, you can duplicate the shape. With the new shape highlighted, reflect it as we did before, but this time horizontally. Then line it up so it's perfectly below the original shape. In the gradient window, you want to make the color furthest away to have zero opacity, and the top color a kind of gray tone. Make sure the side of the zero opacity is also white in color. Drag the slider down so that the shadow reflection blends in really well. I like to lower the opacity of the entire shape here so that it's not so harsh and doesn't stand out too much. Do this for all of your shapes, and you'll end up with something similar to these. I hope this tutorial has been helpful for you guys, and if it has, hit that like button. Be sure to subscribe for weekly tutorials every single Tuesday. I'm changing my other videos from uploading on Saturday to Thursday, so be sure to check those out too. Until next time, remember, design your future today. Peace.